Welcome back to Hello Nigeria. Now we have with us two lovely guests. One of them is a finalist of the first ever Dare to Dream, and she's come to share with us her journey, how it's been for her so far. And joining her to discuss about Dare to Dream is the co-founder of Kinabuti, Francesca. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
So I am dressed in my Kinabuti outfit. How do I look?
Fantastic.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So let's talk very briefly about Kinabuti. You're a fashion. Tell us about Kinabuti and how did you come about the name Kinabuti?
The name Kinabuti comes from Katharina. We started as a fashion label, yeah? So Katharina always wanted to be a designer, so that's how we... And Kinabuti is Katharina Bortolussi. When she was a kid, she was not able to say the full name. So, and then we evolved, you know, we've been here for quite a few years now. And right now we have put a little bit the fashion on the side. And what we're doing is develop talents in fashion and entertainment, creating entrepreneurship, youth entrepreneurship, women entrepreneurship.
Okay, and you said one of the projects you used to achieve this is the Dare to Dream competition. So tell us about Dare to Dream. How did it start and when did it start?
Dare to Dream is the biggest of our projects, and it started in 2014. And it was about, at the beginning it was only about models and girls, only girls. Now we have expanded the category and it's boys and girls, so it's, and we have models, fashion designers, and performing artists.
Okay. Now you were part of the finalists at the first ever Dare to Dream.
That's correct.
Season one. Tell us, what made you decide to go for the Dare to Dream competition and under what category?
Okay, then when I went in for the competition, it was just models. And I was at a point where I was trying to decide if I wanted to do modeling full-time or do it part-time and get like a regular job like we say here. So someone told me about Dare to Dream and Kinabuti, a friend of mine from Port Harcourt, told me to give it a try. I'm like, okay. Let me just go in and see how this would go in.
What was the audition for you like? Now I'm asking because there are many young people that want to go for a lot of all these things and they're thinking, I don't know what to expect. So
yeah.
What was the audition like?
It was very intense. It was very, it required a lot of discipline and participation, but then it was also very educating and I enjoyed every bit of it, although it was very tough, very challenging. Every Dare to Dream participant would say the same thing. From audition to camp is not child's play. It's very hectic. But then it's a training process. And if you're very serious about what you want, it's something that can challenge you into the path which you want to, you know, go into.
All right, Francesca, let's talk about the routine. She talked about from auditions to camp. So they have to be in camp at some point, right?
Yes.
Lead us through the process. So from the very first, if I came to audition for Dare to Dream, what would be the process I'd have to go through?
So first, it's online. So you register online, and this happened like in May, early June. So we were opening the auditions online. And then you have to come to the campus. So you pick the one where you are or the closest to you. And in campus, it's 3 days of auditions. So it's just like, and as she said, it's tough. And it's, you know, there's so many people and it's one after the other, you know, you keep watching. And then if you're picked from the university, then you participate to the boot camp. And the boot camp, it's quite intense, but as Celine was saying, it's very much education, it's very much like teaching them a lot of, not just about their like modeling or designing or a performing artist, but also about how to develop a business plan, how to promote yourself, social media, marketing. So they learn a lot of how to present, how to speak in public, how like etiquette and all these things. Because, well, you can confirm if you're a personal a figure that is on television or anyhow, like, how do you call it? Like
a presenter?
Yes.
Not a personality, yes.
Exactly. You have to know how to, you know, sell yourself as your brand, how to relate also, like, with, I don't know, the producers or other celebrities. So you need to know how also to speak properly and to...
So you train them through all these processes.
Yes.
How long does it take to produce one season of Dare to Dream?
It takes us about, like, let's say 6 months, because first we go around the university and we take little breaks in between. And then It's a boot camp and then the grand finale that is coming soon.
Really? So we've gone through all those processes so far.
We're right now in boot camp, the last few days of boot camp.
Wow. Okay, we'll still come back to talk about that. Celine, let's talk about your experience at the season one, you know, the first ever season of Dare to Dream. What were some of the things you took on? What were some of the things that you learned, the lessons that you learned, or the key skills that you learned while you were in Dare to Dream season one?
Well, for me, what camp taught me was perseverance, being bold and courageous about whatever thing you decide to do. Basically, everything I learned summed up together was, it produced the spirit to push and go after whatever thing I choose to do. And that's basically what.
So you made it to the finals of season one. Let's look at your life between then and now. What has changed?
A lot. It's been, my life has been in a series of progression, both life, in my life generally, and in my career. It's been a series of progression. There has not been any setback or, you know, it's just been moving from one experience to another, basically.
All right, so where are you based now? What do you do now?
Right now, I live in South Africa. I live between Johannesburg and Cape Town. I'm signed to agencies in South Africa. I'm doing full-time modeling. And on the side, I try to get involved with as much as I can to keep my other self active, like my regular girl active.
So you are a model in South Africa?
Yes, I do.
How does that feel? And all this is because you went for Dare to Dream.
Yeah, that was the starting point for me.
And how does that feel? You know, do you miss home sometimes? Do you ever think you want to relocate back, or is it South Africa henceforth?
Of course, I do miss home, but I never think about relocating back. I only think of going forward, going to other countries, and I never think of relocating back immediately.
Why?
Because I have more dreams. I have more ambition. There are other countries I want to work in. There are other people, possibilities out there before I begin to think about coming back. Definitely, I would come back. But at this point in my life, I'm still thinking of more opportunities.
So you are worried
out there
that Nigeria is not yet ready to absorb the awesomeness?
No,
that you have to
not in that sense. Believe me, I've worked in Nigeria. I'm still in touch with the Nigerian market, but there are still countries I've not worked in. If you get what I'm saying. So it's other countries I've not worked
in. Okay, I'll come back to ask you the difference between working as a model in Nigeria and in South Africa. So while you're thinking about that, let's talk to you, Francesca. You work with young people. What would you notice as some of the downsides to being a young person in Nigeria? What are some of the shortcomings, the most common shortcomings that you've noticed amongst young people?
I think they have a lot of possibilities and a lot of opportunities for them here. Sure, like, what is, like, there are, you know, there are a few problems as everywhere that maybe like education, but I think that right now we're in a place and in a moment where if they really want, they can. You know, in the internet, everything is available. You can find any information you want. Even if at school they don't teach you that thing very well, but you have passion for it, you can find information. So I think it's also your own responsibility, you know. And I see all these young students, young youths that we work with. And really, like, when they want, they can achieve, like, things that you think they're impossible, yeah? We're putting up a show in a few days, and they're not professionals, they've never done anything like that, and I'm sure it's going to be a success. I'm sure it's going to be magical.
Let's talk about the show you're putting up in a few days. Where is it happening? And
so it's Thursday.
This Thursday,
in 3 days.
Wow.
Terra Culture, and it's the grand finale of Dare to Dream Season 5, and it's called This is Nigeria.
Interesting. Why that topic? Is it because of Falz's video that was trending?
Well, there's gonna be also that song, but it's because we're presenting. This is the Nigeria that I hope is going to be the future, you know, and yeah, this is the future. So let's forget about all the things that, you know, we complain about, this doesn't work, this doesn't, and let's focus on this youth, their talents, their possibility, that's, and they come from all over, you know, from Jos, from Calabar, from Benin, from Portaco, from Lagos, so east, east, south, south, north, and I think it's good to see, like, this is Nigeria.
Okay. All right, so it's happening on Thursday at Terra Culture. What time?
Red carpet, 7 p.m., and then the show is going to be around 8 o'clock.
Is it free for all? Can anybody just come?
No, invitation only.
Okay.
Invitation only.
Okay. Let's talk to you now, Celine. You've worked as a model in Nigeria, and now you're working as a model in South Africa, and you're aspiring to be a model that travels around the world to fulfill her dreams. What would you say have been the differences? What are the things that you wish we could do differently in the Nigerian modeling industry?
Well, one thing I wish the Nigerian industry would be able to imbibe into the industry is the respect for models and the respect for our jobs. You know, sometimes everywhere it does happen, I don't want to just pin it to just Nigeria. Sometimes people forget models are human beings with feelings, you know. They tend to treat us like we pay you to do a job and just do your job and don't complain or don't. In as much as the models will try to be professional, I just feel they should respect the job we're doing. The way you won't speak to a movie actor or a TV presenter anyhow because he or she tends to be a celebrity to you, you should also be able to accord some sort of respect to a model.
Okay.
And also appreciate whatever.
How about financial remuneration? Does it pay you better to be a model in South Africa? Do you think that there's something we need to do to Nigerian modeling industry with regards to payment?
Yeah.
So back in the day, when I was a lot younger, I had worked as a model as well at some point, and I realized that there wasn't really a lot of money. I don't know what this modeling industry is like right now. I don't know if they're getting paid better. So do you think it's better in South Africa? Would you want better pay for models here in Nigeria as well?
Yeah, I think that too. Better pay, more opportunities, you know. It doesn't have to stay quiet the whole year until Fashion Week and then up the pay a little bit because I hear models still complaining, meaning nothing or not much has changed down here.
Okay, I'll still talk to you again about modeling because there are many young people that want to be models. I mean, I always thought I was going to have my big breakthrough modeling. It didn't happen. But well, you know, all is fair. Let's talk about your quick tips on what is necessary, what is required to be a model. Now, some people just think, oh, if I'm skinny, I'm good enough to be a model, that's it. So yeah. What are your tips and tricks on, or what are the things one needs to know in order for them to be a model? And how are you able to maintain your body?
First, you have to try as much as possible to eat healthy. Try as much as possible to avoid late night eating and snacking. You have to develop a workout routine.
Do you work out as well?
I do a lot. Everybody who knows me knows I enjoy working out. It's not easy. There are days you get lazy, but develop a routine and try as much as possible to stick to it. Develop a skincare routine because the business we are in is about what people see before they get to know you. So you need to keep your skin healthy, looking clean and physically.
All right, interesting. I'm hoping that we've been able to get a few tips from Celine as well on what you need to do if you want to be a model, you know, or you want to maintain that model physique. Before we let you go, Francesca, if you had to speak to young people, you know, young people who are looking to be in a part of Dare to Dream, what are some of the tips you would give to them? Some of them never get called, some of them never scale through. What is that thing that you see in a young person that makes you decide this person is fit enough to be a part of Dare to Dream competition?
Well, I think it's because there are so many wonderful talents around and not everybody, you know, we have limited space, so not everybody gets to be there. So, and I know from like what we've seen that sometimes somebody that is good is not. I just think it's maybe that's not, you know, God works somehow, you know. So it was not meant for you to become a model, but then it was, look what happened to you. So I think it's just like, it's work hard, dedication, discipline, listen, And if it's meant to you, if it's meant for you, it will go on. Otherwise, there will be a lot of other like fantastic opportunities. So, but really, it's yeah, work hard, believe, have your dream, know, focus, know what you want. You know, I want to do this, I want to do that. Focus on one thing at a time, and then you can, as you get that one done, then you can achieve other ones. Sometimes they don't have really like the full idea of, even because they don't know what the industry can offer them and what are the opportunities. But I really believe there are a lot of opportunities in this Nigeria. Dare to Dream is one, but there are so many others. So it's really, and I think for the youth that this is the best time. This is the best time to be here. This is the best time for them, like thanks to the technology and everything. And really they have amazing opportunities.
Fantastic. I like what you said. Focus on one thing at a time. You find that lots of people want to do everything at the same time. I've been guilty of that as well. And sometimes the risk in doing that is you're not able to give your best to one. Your energy is scattered. Rather than scatter it, concentrate on one thing and give it your full force. Execute that one and then move to the next. Your final thoughts on someone who wants to be a model, what words of advice would you give to them? There are people who want to take modeling as a full-time career. Now, we haven't totally gotten to a part in Nigeria where you can wake up and when you're done with secondary school, say to your parents, I want to go into modeling full-time. I mean, how was it for you? Did your, were your parents very open to it at first?
No, it's very difficult.
What did they want you to be at first? Or what did you
want? I actually worked in a bank for 2 years before they let me go, because at first my parents wanted me to be an accountant. I went through universities, and when I graduated and I was insisting I want to be a full-time model, it was very difficult. So I got a regular job. I worked as a banker for 2 years, and eventually I'm like, I'm not happy here. I really need to do modeling. So my mom was like, okay, if that's what you want, I mean, you're of age now, go for it. And I decided, okay, maybe I should take it outside Nigeria. At least if whatever is worth doing good. So for any Nigerian girl who wants to become a full-time model, like you said, it's very difficult to be a full-time model here. I would advise do it part-time, build a portfolio. On the other hand, go to school, get a career somewhere else while you do it part-time and build your portfolio. Get a good agency that is able to push you internationally. And as soon as you get signed, you can decide to do it full-time. Because advising anyone to do modeling in Nigeria full-time, I do not know how realistic that would be. But whatever way you decide to go for modeling, it's best you go in with determination, go in with a thick skin, because you go to casting sometimes and you get told no. That no shouldn't be the end of the journey for you. If you really want to be a model, persevere, like I say. Perseverance is key for anyone who wants to go into modeling.
Speaking of thick skin, do you have times when you've had negative remarks being made about your physical appearance?
Of course.
You know that the modeling industry is a very physical industry.
And yeah.
Have you ever heard any negative remarks?
A lot of it. I've had a lot of it. Like I said, I grew a thick skin. It didn't happen in one day. I stopped modeling a few times. I just had a best friend who kept telling me, you should, if you really want to do it, give it a try. And every time I'm like, you know what, I'm done with modeling, she'll be like, but you still love it. It makes you sad to leave it. Go for it. So it's something one should train his or herself on to build that thick skin, because you will get told a lot of things. I've been reminded I have a scar on my left hand which has been used against me. Or sometimes they tell me I'm too skinny. Other times they tell me I'm too fat. It depends on who is casting you at that point in time. So I got to the point where I told myself, if it's not my job, I would be told I don't fit in. So I learned to accept it.
So learn to understand that no is not necessarily a rejection.
Yes.
No might just mean try again. Thank you so much for joining
us. It's a
pleasure. And thank you for being very honest about the Nigerian modeling industry and the advice you gave to people. What I would say is, now that you've seen that vacuum and that lacuna, maybe you can now think of ways to coming back home at some point to ensure that you fix that problem, so that people who want a full-time career in modeling don't have to travel abroad, get international recognition before they're being accepted here. So please think about that, and we look forward to seeing you in the nearest future, you know, doing amazing things back here in Nigeria.
Thank you.
And we wish you all the best as well with the season finale or the grand finale of Dare to Dream.
Yes, happening on Thursday. To see you there.
Yes, I'd love to come. Happening on Thursday at Terra Culture, 7 p.m. the glitz and the glam and the best of the industry should be there. And of course, Wazobia Max should be there to cover it as well. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.